Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, you know, over the last 5 weeks, I think I've taken about 14 episodes now looking at Excel 2010. Time to move on, get back to your Excel questions. One last trick here is in 2007 they changed the behavior of these buttons up here. It used to be that this button would close the current workbook and the X at the top would close Excel, but in 2007 they changed this. The one at the top doesn't close Excel, it just closes the current workbook until you get down to the point where there's only one workbook open. And what not many people knew, or the people who did know it discovered it by mistake, in 2007 you would have to double click the office icon instead to close Excel, and you can no longer do that. If you double click the office icon, it just takes you to the backstage view, so we don't have an exit. They added this new menu up here, and I thought that the new menu would give us a way to close Excel, but instead it still just closes the current workbook. I thought maybe I could right click here on exit and say add to quick access toolbar, but for some reason that's not working. So if you want to be able to close Excel, what we can do is go to the quick access toolbar, say customize quick access toolbar, ask for all commands, and then come down to the ease to find exit Excel, and you can add that to your quick access toolbar. Kind of strange that it is really just this difficult to have one click access to close Excel. There you have it, Excel 2010, great new version of Excel. They took a lot of the features in Excel 2007, you know, allowed you to customize the ribbon, which I think is a really good thing. That way you can have pivot tables on the data tab if that's where you want them. Spark lines, some new conditional formatting, better smart art, great picture tools, lots of new statistical functions. You remember Mike Gervin telling you about those, slicers, all kinds of great, great features coming in either Q1 or early Q2 of 2010. So hopefully you'll look forward to that. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.